So let the games begin. Here we go, the medal matches in this men's surfing tournament at these Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games from Surikasaki Surfing Beach here on the east coast of Japan. For the bronze medal, first up, wearing the red jersey, the two-time world champion, Gabriel Medina. And his opponent, from New South Wales in Australia, the 31-year-old, Owen Wright.
Two great goofy footers on form this week. It's a very even match. Advantage to Medina, perhaps in the air. Maybe an advantage on the wave face to Owen Wright. He's been doing incredible vertical backhand surfing. Really hasn't had to go to the air to impress the judges. We see them both, the introductions are done, making their way down to the beach. And about a 2 or 3 minute paddle out today. It's a lot of white water. Low tide was around 1 o'clock, 12:50, and we see now, we're past the low, the tide's coming in, but it's made the conditions quite difficult to read. Owen Wright's wave selection to date has been incredible. Very controlled professional performance from the Australian to this point in the event.
And once again, Barton, we're seeing both athletes head towards the left-hand side of the beach. It seems that is the place to go. On day one, they were down the right-hand side underneath the big screen next to that jetty. But as the tournament has progressed, they've gone further left down the beach, and that's where these big waves seem to be.
And everybody's going there, so it must be right. You know, we've got the best surfers in the world, coaching staff, paying all of the attention. And wave selection in surfing is what it's all about. The better the wave, the better the opportunity to score big. And as it says there, this is the bronze medal match. Really, I immediately just feel for the surfer who ends up in that fourth place, doesn't get a medal. So this match really is it's an emotional situation. Owen Wright taking some water. Coach B. Durbridge, former professional surfer himself. Great surfer. And there you look at the tail of that board, a rounded pin, three fins on the bottom of the board. Those fins there to stabilize, to bring projection and speed to the performance.
Owen Wright making his way out onto the water. Play due to begin in 3.5 minutes from now, which gives us enough time to just explain what our judges, who are sitting in that tower on that first floor deck, panel of five.
International panel to represent that international flavour of surfing in the modern day. Five elements that are considered here. Commitment and degree of difficulty. So commitment meaning that when you're on your ride, the earlier you do your turns, the more you risk, because you've got the whole rest of the wave that you're risking if you fall off at the start of the wave. So the turns and the manoeuvres done at the beginning of a wave are ordinarily considered more risky, and the judges like that. So more commitment in that, as we see Owen Wright paddling out down by that break wall. The second area, innovative and progressive manoeuvres, and we've seen a lot of that this week. Really, that seems to be the primary thing that the judges are looking for. You've got the combination of major manoeuvres. We've seen this week, though, that one manoeuvre, one aerial manoeuvre is enough to go near perfect. We saw Italo Ferreira get a 9.73 for one massive aerial manoeuvre. So the combination of the manoeuvres is important, but not everything at this point in time. And with the interpretation the judges have brought to this event, the variety of manoeuvres, so being able to show, they don't want to see the same thing over and over. They need you to continue to entertain them. And then speed, power and flow. The faster you go, the more power and strength and aggression you put into what you do. But then again, it's a dance on a wave, and it needs to be sequenced and brought together in a nice flowing manner where if you lose control, they don't like that. You get, you know, your scores go down if you lose control. So the flow and that you bring to your performance is also important.
This is the bronze medal match. Medina losing out to Igarashi in the semi-finals, and Owen Wright losing now to Brazil's Italo Ferreira Both of them gentlemen will meet in the gold medal match later, but this is for bronze.
And the waves are scored out of 10. You can ride as many waves as you want, but it's your best two that count, your highest two scores. There's five judges on the panel. Knock off the high and the low. Average those three scores in the middle. And to give you an idea of the judging scale, generally speaking, 0 to 2 points is poor, 2 to 4 points is fair. 4 to 6 is an average ride, and we've seen people win heats with that average, high average type scores. So in today's conditions, kind of a pretty messy ocean there. 6-point rides have been valuable, and people have been keeping them in their final two. A 6 to an 8 is good, and an 8 to 10 is excellent.
Been two different approaches by both of these athletes during these games. Owen Wright has gone the more considered, conservative approach, taking his time, assessing the ocean and selecting his waves carefully, unlike Medina, who's gone hell for leather, as it were.
yes. So and that sort of conservative, controlled, almost professional and managed approach of Owen Wright has applied to his surfing on the wave and his wave selection. Where Medina, on the other hand, it's been a little more frenetic. He's caught a lot of waves, and then he's approached the wave. His surfing performance on the wave has had that same kind of abandon to it, where he's just thrown himself at everything. And when it sticks, big scores drop from the judges. When you don't stick, the score immediately goes down to more or less nothing. But he's definitely keen to have a go. I think we just heard the siren.
The hooter goes. And for these medal matches, an extra 5 minutes is given to all the athletes. 35 minutes they have to find the best two waves possible, and the winner will take home an Olympic bronze medal.
And this wide shot's a great time to assess the conditions, and you can see how much white water there is way out the back. On this earlier in the day with the higher tide, they weren't breaking out there, and the energy was moving in onto the inside where the surfers are. Now with the just past that dead low tide, the low tide means there's less water on the sand, and so these sets outside, as you can see to the right there and off to the left, they're breaking way outside, and that's stealing some of the energy from those sets. They make their way through to the inside where these guys are catching them, both sitting quite close to each other. They've met before. There's a great history between these two guys.
Yeah, the head-to-head, Medina leads 6-4 in their 10 tussles on the championship tour, and Medina is trying to look to open his account.
Up and riding, nice big face in front of him, pumping, driving, looking for the air. Here's a whoa! You could see there was ribs from the wind. There were ribs on the wave face, and we'll see it in the replay as he came along. The board just lost control of the rail, and you don't see Gabriel Medina make mistakes like that very often. The board was submerged under the white water there. You couldn't see the board for a moment. I thought he might have lost it. Might have had a leg rope malfunction and. But there's the board still with him. The leg rope is the cord that you put around your ankle, and it connects to the tail of your board and keeps your surfboard right there with you.
Just a 0.77 given for that effort from our judges. Do athletes sometimes go out and think of a rough target score? They think, I'll tell you what, against this opponent, I think that might be enough to take the victory.
Oh, here we go. Let's look at this replay. See the rib there, and you saw the board just wobble on the rib. He ends up upside down, head first, down into the breaking part of the wave. So an unorthodox wipe out there. And again, you don't see Gabriel Medina make mistakes like that very often. His mind was focused at the top of the wave, looking at the lip, which is where he's going to use that top part of the wave as a ramp, like a skateboard or wood, to fly into the air. And as he was looking at the lip, that below his board there were these ribs running through the wave that made the rail of the board, which is the side of the board, lose its contact and its control with the water, and consequently had a ugly little wipe out there. And so to the point about understanding scores, and maybe you're not always just going out there to look for tens. Some surfers do, and I think Gabriel Medina is one of those guys. He'll just go out there and he might ride 10, 15 waves, but he might fall on 12 of them. But if he sticks those ones, they're the big, big scores. We saw him get two mid-range eights in the previous heat that he lost in. So he's scored really well in his past heat, even though he lost to Kanoa Igarashi.
Indeed, it was an 8-4-3 and an 8-3-3 is what he scored in his semi-final. Kanoide Garashi found a 9.33 in the last 6 minutes.
Medina's having another look. There's a bit of white water. Cut back there to the white water. He loves these early starts, likes to get busy. Good idea too in these random conditions. You can sit and wait and select and jump to your feet on what you think is the perfect wave, and then all of a sudden a wind rib will run across it. It'll hit a different weird piece of sand, fill up, and they just change so consistently. So chancing your hand consistently means that, you know, it's hit and miss a little bit out there. The more you have a go, the more that your chances rise up of actually hitting, you know, and hitting the right type of wave.
In the quarterfinals and semifinals, we saw very consistent waves. Now, after the tide, this looks a bit more of a lottery.
Yeah, Owen Wright, up and riding. Patient, beautiful carving turn out of the top there. Driving out of the bottom, another beautiful turn. And while the... That was confident, seamless surfing. We talked about that judging criteria and the speed, power and flow and the combination of those major manoeuvres. Both of those categories were just ticked perfectly there by Owen Wright.
This is something that he has done throughout this Olympic Games. He seems to build his score, getting the fives, getting the sixes and just lay the foundations every heat, and this is another example of that.
Do you see how long he waited and how long he is staying on the rail of the board, which is the side of the board, and you sink it into the water like he did just right there, and then he transfers to the other rail, sinks the rail deep into the wave and gouges the turn, but at the same time maintains speed. If you stick that rail into the water and lose speed, we call that bogging, and it slows the board down. But Owen Wright there was, he just maintained his speed and fluidity beautifully through that ride. That was a really, really nicely surfed first wave from Owen Wright.
Medina's up.
Here he goes, waiting for it to stand up in front of him. Nice re-entry. Here's a better section. Will he go to the air? Yes, he does. He lands it, lays back. Will he come out of the white water? We know the judges don't count them if you don't complete it, but he did. Great surfing, and that exchange there speaks to the two differences between these surfers. Owen Wright stays on the wave face, a more traditional style of surfing, carving with beautiful speed and flair. He's up and riding again, quick in and out. Gabriel Medina, on the other hand, he takes that more modern aerialistic approach and just tries to fly at any chance he gets.
We're still waiting for Owen Wright's first score to come in. Here is the replay of Medina.
Let's have a look at this first turn. Drops down, sees the section ahead, pops off it beautifully, lands on the board, lays back into the water. So that layback part of it, it adds drama and it's exciting, but at the same time it is in part a little bit of a loss of control in that manoeuvre. Obviously, compared to the manoeuvres of Owen Wright, much more difficult, a much higher degree of difficulty coming into things there for Gabriel Medina, but there was a loss of control. He did maintain it, did hold it. Be interesting to see whether he gets the judges look at that and go, oh, it's a loss of control, or whether the drama of that moment is something they enjoy.
Owen Wright's first wave was a 6.5. That goes with the grain, basically, of what we've seen from him so far. Medina, we're still waiting for his third wave score to come in. But for Owen Wright, that's basically what we've seen from him in this whole competition.
Yeah, and it was very well scored. I mean, you think about the scale from 0 to 10. So there's 3.5 points room that you could improve upon that. And that was, it was a beautifully surfed wave, but it was sort of a traditional basic style of surfing, I suppose you could say. Beautifully done, beautifully executed, but again, it was a traditional style. Gabriel Medina's, on the other hand, there was higher risk. It was something that was, I think that Medina may get the edge here with that opening exchange.
Still waiting for that score to come in. For those of you who are new to the sport, the judges will see the waves from these athletes are only at one angle, and they see them one at a time. So sometimes there is a delay of a couple of minutes for these scores to land. They don't land instantly like you see in other sports such as gymnastics or ice dancing. They do take a good long look so they can judge these surfers fairly.
And those sports are great examples because this is a subjective sport as well. And so when you're watching this, the wave being ridden, you see there's criteria that they tick and things they've got to achieve, but at the same time, it's an interpretation of the overall performance. And a judge or us as the audience, we're left with a feeling of what that is, and then the judges will take that feeling, look at the replay, see how it fits in and how they tick those boxes in terms of the areas that they've got to match, and then they come up with a score. It's not a science. There's a, you know, it is definitely subjective, but the more you're around it, the more you understand it. And we see the score come in there, a 5.43. So really interesting exchange there. The more traditional approach of Owen Wright being judged higher than the, you know, new school aerial approach of Gabriel Medina, and it does talk to the layback and the loss of control. And perhaps the judges there saw that loss of control. That was he did reclaim it and get back up to his feet and complete it, but the loss of control was something that hampered the scoring potential of that.
10 minutes down, 25 minutes to go. This is the bronze medal match of the men's surfing tournament here at Surigasaki Surfing Beach. This is where we stand after 10 minutes. Owen Wright of Australia, 6.5 and a 2.1 gives the Australian an 8.6 total. Gabriel Medina, former double world champion, 5.43 and a 1.00 to give him a 6.43 total. But there's still a long way to go.
Yeah, and you see the P1 and the P2 next to their names, just next to the scores there. The P standing for priority. First priority, obviously the one, with Gabriel Medina at the moment. What that means is that he has the right of way. Owen Wright, if Gabriel Medina wants a wave, Owen Wright can't take it. And so Gabriel Medina uses that in an attacking way and also sometimes in a defensive way. We see the defensive use of it ordinarily more towards the end of a heat, where you can control what your opponent can and can't get by using that priority, by being close to him. And it's something that, you know, in these random conditions, to be near your opponent sort of controls the luck and the opportunity for that luck to influence it. Gabriel Medina paddles, loses the priority for paddling for that wave, switches to Owen Wright, a mistake there.
Medina with an unforced error, but he's back up straight away.
Great rebound, looking for the air, slowing his board down, waiting for the wave to stand up in front of him. Here he goes to the air, rotates, massive rotation, and unfortunately catches the rail, comes unstuck.
That was a great angle as well, just to see how he rode that wave as well.
And you can see him he just holds the board back, holds the ball back, like putting the handbrake on, just waiting, and then releases, lets the momentum take him forward into the lip. Unfortunately, he didn't complete it. It was going to be a massive score if he made that.
If he did land that, it would have been somewhere in the high eights, low nines.
Yeah, that excellent range. Excellent being between 8 and 10 points. The highest wave of the event so far is a 9.73.
To which one judge actually gave a 10 and another judge a 9.9. So goes to show how good that wave actually was from Italo Ferreira earlier on in his quarterfinal.
Two judges, a 9.5, one a 9.8. You knock off the high and the low and average those three to get the score out of 10.
Seven waves have been caught by these pair of athletes. This was the latest one from Medina.
Pumping into this closeout section, hits the lip, rotates. If he would have, and you see, he was on his way around again. That was an over rotation. It shows the potential that this guy has in the air, because the board, if it hadn't gone to that side and landed on that rail, he could have completed up and riding again. Oh no, that's the same one. Just the replay from the air. Great camera angles here. We're seeing it from all different angles. The judges in their replays only see it from the one angle so that they bring consistency to their judging. Waves can look different. Turns can look different from different angles. So what's great, we get that opportunity to view it in so many ways.
Seven waves ridden so far. Owen Wright's first wave, a 6.5. He's followed it with a 2.1 with his third wave to give that total of 8.6. Medina, a 5.43 on his third wave and a 1.10 on his fourth. Gives the Brazilian a total of 6.53. Right now, his target to surpass the Australian is 3.18, and we should expect to see that in the next 20 minutes or so.
The second waves at this point in time are inconsequential. Don't see that they will be holding on to those in 21 and a half minutes time. The 6.5 from Owen Wright potentially could be held on to. Sure, that 5.43, Gabriel Medina would not want to keep that in his final two-wave tally.
21 minutes of play left. Medina, a former double world champion, 16 times a winner on the championship tour. Winner twice this season. Owen Wright has had a quiet season, but he's brought his best form here to Tokyo.
Sure has. Career best form we've seen this week. Up and riding, in and out. Medina, always hungry, always fossicking and prowling around the lineup, trying to find opportunity. And in these type of conditions, it's a great idea, but in stark contrast, Owen Wright has not done that at all, not in a single heat. He has been so deliberate and so determined. He's known what he was looking for. He knows the type of waves he's looking for, and he's just taken his time to make sure he finds those.
Owen Wright with priority. So far in control.
And hence the distance between the two. Gabriel Medina, you imagine you go and sit near Owen Wright, and he's got that priority. He can control what you can and can't catch. If you move away from him, you sort of open up the chances for the random nature of the ocean to influence things. A little bit of luck to go your way. That's what he's looking for, and he's going to be up and riding right here, going on the backhand into the air. Lands it, slides off the back of his board, and there's a sort of feeling somewhere in me that the confidence that he had shown earlier on and the consistency in those airs doesn't seem to quite be there now. There's been a lot of incomplete air attempts, which is unlike Gabriel.
Could that be due to the changing conditions over the last hour?
Or the pressure of the moment? Take your pick. But for me, I think it's more the pressure of this moment. Gabriel has amazing consistency to those airs, and it also speaks to strategy. Perhaps you go out there and you ride your first couple of waves in a more traditional sense. Owen Wright, for example, you get your 6.5s, your 7s, whatever you can that way, create a foundation, and then you go for the wild moves. And if you don't succeed, you've already got some foundations that will, you know, give you support for the rest of the heat. Going for that stuff without the foundation in place can be dangerous at times.
Medina needs a 3.18 to take the lead.
And he wouldn't be looking at it in that way. He wouldn't look and go, no. I just need a 3.0. Way too early to be thinking about that. He's looking for 8-plus rides. Into the excellent range. And we've seen him do it consistently, you know, through this day. He lost his quarterfinal with 2 mid-range eights, so perhaps he knows he needs even more than that. Paddling, having a look at this inside one. Up and riding. Lumpy little wave, taking his time. Weaving around. Beautiful backhand re-entry. He has the turns to just rely on the turns. He doesn't... Oh, bumpy, lumpy wave. See that bit coming at him across?
So that would be Medina's 7th wave that he's ridden so far in this contest. Owen Wright is keeping to his game plan. He's only had 3 so far in the first half of this contest.
Exactly, they're competing exactly how they have for, you know, through this competition. Same strategies, obviously they've worked for each other to this point. And you asked that question before about understanding what scores you want and going out there looking for specific scores. I think the important thing is to know the minimum and what you're not going to go. You know, you obviously don't want anything under a 6. Anything under a 6, really, at this level of competition is a waste of time. It takes you out of the lineup. You've got to ride the wave, paddle back out. 2 or 3 minutes are burnt off the clock for something that you're not going to keep.
Patience really is a key when it comes to these important heats and important matches, and wave selection must be crucial.
Yes, because the quality of the wave determines the quality of the performance. And without you putting yourself on the best waves available, if you're on the best waves, your chances of getting those best scores are so much more than having to try and manufacture a score on a wave that doesn't even have that score in it and just rely on your surfing to get the score. Makes the whole process much harder. And the process is made easier by good wave selection. And the best surfers in the world get the best waves. They know the waves, they know the ocean, because being a professional surfer, there's these two areas of surfing, and the first pillar is everything that happens before you stand up. That is surfing. That's your understanding of the ocean, your relationship with it, and that's really what surfing's about. And for people beginning surfing and your recreational surfers, you need to recognize that part of surfing as being really important. That's your ocean craft and your knowledge of the ocean. And then there's the gymnastic stuff that happens once you're up and riding on the wave, which really is secondary, and you need to do that first pillar really well for the second pillar to have an opportunity to shine.
Just over 15 minutes left in this contest. Gabriel Medina has closed the gap. His seventh wave scored 3.07. Gives him a grand total of 8.50. Owen Wright still leads on 8.60. Medina's target is still 3.18 to surpass the Australian. But as we expect, we're expecting a high score to come somewhere in this bronze medal match.
Oh, absolutely. And from both surfers, Gabriel Medina's just got to stick one of those crazy big airs that he does. Owen Wright will stick to the recipe of trying to find those beautiful waves and rely on that magnificent backhand attack. And now in surfing, you've got goofy footers and natural footers. Goofy footers surf with their right foot forward, natural footers with their left foot forward, and there's neither way is better than the other, although goofies think it's better to be goofy and naturals think it's better to be natural. But in the end, there's no advantage either way, and there's no real reason why one person surfs one way or the other. It's not because you're left-handed or right-handed. It doesn't really have any relationship to that. It's really just about the way that you jump to your feet that very first time and how you stand up naturally.
This is where we stand with just under 15 minutes to go. Owen Wright of Australia in the lead, 6.5 wave, one of the first waves he caught. In fact, it was the first. That's the highest wave of the heat so far. He's joined it with a 2.10 to get that total of 8.6. Medina, a 5.43 and a 3.07 to give the Brazilian a score of 8.5. Medina needs a 3.18 to take the lead.
And he needs to, you know, at least match that 6.5. Match the highest scoring ride of Owen Wright's, and then start to think about the second wave.
We have spoken during these last few days about the amount of boards that a surfer will bring to a contest, reading that Geordie Smith took 28 down to Australia on those legs. Will they have changed due to these conditions compared to how they surfed in the morning?
No, you'd be riding the same equipment, and there's a lot to be said. A magic board, you know, there's good boards, there's magic boards, and the magic boards are the ones that they tend to go in anything. And you can ride them from 1 foot to 6 foot. Doesn't matter whether it's offshore or onshore. Doesn't matter whether it's sucky or full. A magic board will go in anything. And that's what people are after. You're trying to find the magic board that delivers you consistency so you don't have to think about it and chop and change depending on the conditions. You've got the magic one. You break her out. Ordinarily, you don't ride them very often. You save them for the heats because you don't want to break them, and then you dust them off for the heats and get back on, and you've got that familiarity with them and consistency, and they're the ones that everybody is looking for, are the magic ones. Now, surfboards are shaped, you know, generally speaking, by a machine, and they're designed on a computer, and then the machine pumps them out, and then to those specifications, and then you sand them down and tweak them a little bit and glass them. So consistency now in surfboards is something that is way higher than it used to be. Gabriel Medina, backhand vertical re-entry. What's he got next? Another little snap off the top, going to a traditional style of surfing, because he just needs to bank some scores. He just got that 3.18, no worries. He's going to go into the lead. It wasn't a great ride, but at least it put some pressure on Owen Wright.
Owen Wright has only surfed three waves so far. That was Medina's eighth. And as you mentioned, I think that it was a case of surfing a wave just to get rid of that 3.07 score. Maybe somewhere in the five range, and he'll take the lead and put the pressure on his opponent.
And it's about competing smart. You know, there's here we go, up and riding. Pumping, driving, sees the lip in front of him. Floater re-entry, comes around, he's still got room. Beautiful snap there. This is a great, we haven't seen many good left-handers. This is one of the best ones we've seen all day. Surfing on his forehand, three lovely turns, great answer back. That's going to be a better score than Gabriel Medina's wave, most probably. Bigger, more open face, and it just seemed like there was more time to enjoy it, where Gabriel was really trying to manufacture something.
Did Medina force him to do that?
No, I don't think so. I think that was a choice. And, you know, time's ticking. Yeah, we've lost, 24 minutes has gone by already in this heat. And so I think Owen Wright was, you know, Medina was still making his way out. And Owen Wright was like, I need to get a second score. I don't want to let Gabriel start building momentum. I need to keep that pressure on him. And by getting that wave, he did just that. So I think he'll most probably get the better of that exchange. Let's watch it here. The start, that floater there, things got a little soupy and ugly on the face. But this turn was good. The judges will like that. And then this bonus section. See, he popped over into this lovely sort of chunky little bit that was a bonus. Got a lovely wrapping cut back there. Completed it cleanly. And here's Medina's. Let's have a look at this. Beautiful backhand reentry. Both these guys are incredible on the backhand. Second turn a bit flat. You can see the wave's gone really flat. And this is where he's really kind of working and trying to build the score into something. Three turns each, but I feel like Owen's was sort of done on a little more face and it was a little more exciting to watch. I see a slight advantage on that exchange to Owen Wright. He's got the advantage on the best one wave. He may have an advantage on the best two waves now and have a sort of strong position to build on.
With 10 minutes to go, we're still waiting for both of those scores to land. So expect the score to change in the top left of your screen and I'll tell you what those wave scores will be. The reason for the delay, both of those surfers went at roughly the same time, so the judges will look at one first and then another before inputting the scores. So hence why this is sometimes a little bit of a delay, but as soon as those scores land, you'll be the first to hear.
And they may look at them several times as well to digest it properly and put it in context. And every score has got to be in relation to every other score. And so you look at all the number of rides, 8 for Gabriel Medina. All of those rides have got to make sense in relation to each other. And there's this idea of keeping scale, they call it, where the judges have got to keep things the way it should be and have it all balanced and make sense.
9 minutes to go, those scores yet to land.
Because this is a really important point. That was a really important exchange. And so the judges will take their time. Owen Wright's having a look. Priority with Owen Wright. He's decided to use it. He liked the feeling on that last left-hander. He doesn't like the feeling on this one so much.
Owen Wright's score's coming as a 5.47 for Owen Wright. So for Medina to surpass him, he needs a 6.54. And we're still waiting for his score to land as well.
5.47 for Owen Wright, kind of matches that 5.43, a slight advantage there on the second wave. I feel like that's going to, 5.43 most probably will be Gabriel's second wave. But again, it wasn't such a big wave, it wasn't such a good wave. And the better the wave, the more excited you get. And as a surfer and as a judge, they're all surfers, the judges. They want to see you on waves that they want to surf. If you're on a wave that doesn't get them excited, they look at it and go, I wouldn't have caught that one. Then they're not going to score it. But if they look at it and go, oh, and they get excited because it's something they want to ride, your chances of getting a good score from them are much better. 8 minutes on the clock.
5.77 for Medina. So it was better than Owen Wright's according to the judges, but it's not enough to pass the Australian. Medina needs a 6.21 with 7 minutes and 45 seconds to go to take the bronze medal. Right now, it's in the palm of Owen Wright. This is where we stand with 7 minutes and change to go. Owen Wright, 6.5 and a 5.47. He has the lead with 11.97 overall. Medina, a 5.77 and a 5.43 to give the Brazilian 11.2. And Wright is off and running once more, in and out.
Much harder to find the good ones now. It's not as obvious. That low tide has impacted the conditions and it's making the wave selection really difficult. And this is where that understanding of the ocean really comes into it. Such an important part of surfing, the relationship you have with it. And in this big, massive random ocean, being able to put yourself in the right place at the right time. is not an easy thing to do, but for these guys, ordinarily it is. Gabriel Medina in and out as well. You can see that both of these guys are actually at that point where time's ticking down. They realise they're only in the fives and sixes, which, you know, 1-8 from anyone is just going to blow things out of the water. And so they're really doing their very best. Look, he needs to know the scores. He wants to understand the situation so he knows what strategy to employ. He has the first priority at this point in time.
That's the reason both hands above the head, he's signalling he wants to know what the scores are.
Yeah, and if they point to the wrist, they want to know the time. And understanding the scores, it's a mathematical equation, the whole thing. And so they need to know the scores to know. It gives you an indication of what you're doing, whether it's right or wrong. Medina up and riding, maybe. Yes, just gets in. Bouncing at the top of this wave, trying to get an entry in. At the last minute, gets one, goes to the air and completes it.
Fist pump from the Brazilian. Maybe, just maybe, that could be the wave he was looking for. 6.21 is what he needs to take the lead in this bronze medal tie.
And fair to say it was a terrible wave with an amazing manoeuvre on it. And that's what the Brazilians, Italo Ferreira, Gabriel Medina, they can turn twos into tens. And there's not many surfers that can do that. Most surfers need to, you know, be on a good wave to get a good score. That was a terrible wave. But what he does here, look, sees the closeout part, hits it. Gets height, tail was very high, rotates cleanly and makes it. It's the first one that he's completed in a while and in this heat as well, so he'll be really happy with that. The judges, this is going to be a great indication of how the judges feel about the surfing, because the whole event so far has been about the airs. I feel like they're going to reward that, because at this point in time, there was a lot of risk.
5 minutes to go. We're still waiting for that score to land. The likelihood is it's going to be around about the 6 to 8 mark, maybe even more. Medina's back for more.
In and out. Continuing to try his luck. Great aerial manoeuvre there. Air reverse out of the lip. He was barely on his feet. He just got to his feet, pump, 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 and then took to the air. So it was, you know, it was created and manufactured through pure skill. The wave didn't really help him much.
It was only a 6. Only a 6 for Medina. Owen Wright still with the lead, but the target has been reduced. It's now 5.98 for Medina, and he will take the lead.
This is the bronze medal match. Remember, a lot riding on this situation, but the wave itself was a 1. It was a terrible wave. To turn that wave into a 6 shows the potential he has. So I think there's a lot of positives to take out of that at this point in time. Owen Wright sitting with the priority. Gabriel Medina will stay away from him and just keep surfing and keep trying to chip away at the lead of Owen Wright. The Australian, as you said, he's got his hands on that bronze medal right now.
When does Owen Wright start attaching himself to Medina? He has priority right now.
Looks like he was paddling that way for a second there. He wants the information as well. Here we go. Medina, looked like there was a bit of an inside wave there that could have been standing up for Medina. Owen Wright's moving now. 3 minutes and 20 seconds on the clock. A good time to go and be Medina's best mate.
For those of you who are new to surfing, this is the tactical part of the game. When you got the lead, this is like football's version, or you got a 1-0 lead and you're putting the ball next to the corner flag.
And if you're sitting next to Gabriel Medina with the priority, you can control what he catches and what he doesn't catch. And it's vitally important that you use it that way. Medina paddling. He's trying to get away from Owen Wright. Owen Wright's like, I'm coming with you. And Owen Wright's, he's got some long arms. He's a very strong paddler. Medina's having a look at this little inside one. You can't let Gabriel catch anything, because anything could be turned into a 10. Here he goes. There's going to be an air here. Whoa. Lost his footing, ended up on his backside on the board. But that shows what he's capable of. He doesn't need much of a wave. So it's really hard for Owen Wright to stop him, especially when he's so busy and moving around so much. He's only got 2.5 minutes, though.
The clock is ticking. 2:25 for Gabriel Medina, the double world champion. One of the favourites to take the gold here. He may not be taking home a medal. Owen Wright of Australia, 31-year-old from New South Wales, 2 minutes and 10 seconds away from taking home an Olympic bronze.
Drives into the section, pops into the air, and you can see he had some ideas of what he was going to do, but the wind got under the board and the pressure of the moment came to bear, And it was an uncharacteristic wipeout there. We've seen a couple of them in this bronze medal match from Gabriel Medina. He's trying so hard. It means so much, obviously. The loser here, or the fourth place surfer here, doesn't get a medal. So a lot riding on this situation. Owen Wright looking over his shoulder, looking towards the shore, trying to see where Gabriel Medina is. Medina's got 1.5 minutes, but look, he's way inside. It's going to take him at least 30 seconds to get back out the back. He's not going to have much time. He may not get another chance. The Australian may have... He's got his hands on that bronze. Will he keep it?
And Medina is a long way away from the waves here, a long way away, and he's 75 seconds away from defeat. He needs to find a 5.98 in the last 70 seconds. Owen Wright, there's nothing much more he can do. All he can do is block Medina.
Well, or catch a wave and improve himself.
Indeed.
That's where his focus should be at this point in time.
60 seconds to go. Medina.
1 minute. I don't think Medina's going to make it back out. I don't think he gets another chance. I feel like Owen Wright may have the bronze. There's a lot of white water. You can see one wave there. There's a wave immediately behind it. 45 seconds. Medina's still got a little way to travel. If he does get out, he's only going to have 10, 15 seconds to find a wave. He needs to find it as soon as he arrives out the back, or even something on the way out the back, before he even gets all that way. And if he does get all that way, I bet you Owen Wright's going to be right near him.
30 seconds to go. Medina paddling for his life. He needs to find a wave in the next 25 seconds. Otherwise, he leaves Tokyo empty-handed. Owen Wright of Australia, 20 seconds away from an Olympic bronze medal. And Wright is there to meet Gabriel Medina as well. 15 seconds to go. Here comes Medina. He's in the last dying embers of this bronze medal match. Owen Wright of Australia, he's nearly there. 6 seconds, five, he's got the priority and he's away, and he's going to take home an Olympic bronze medal.
Yes, the victory lap for Owen Wright. A bronze medal for the Australian. The team are ecstatic. Great effort. And Gabriel Medina's a tough scalp. Fantastic effort. Well done, young man.
Well done indeed. The road to recovery is complete for Owen Wright. It's an amazing story, who had to come back from a nearly life-threatening injury 4 years ago.
And Gabriel Medina came into this event as the form surfer in the world. Everyone was expecting him to possibly be the gold medalist. Owen Wright defeating him for the bronze.
Owen Wright is the men's Olympic bronze medalist. And just look what it means to him. The Irukandjis, that's what they've called themselves. Rebranded themselves, the Australian team, after the deadliest jellyfish in the sea. And my word,
this is a deadly result for Australia.
Indeed it is.
Great to get a medal.
Just look what it means to Owen Wright, who suffered a horrendous injury in Fiji a few years ago. Had to learn to surf again. And this is the reward for all that hard work.
Oh, you watch this. This is going to be great. I think they've been rehearsing some of these celebrations. Stephanie Gilmore, Sally Fitzgibbon, Julian Wilson, the Australian team.
Owen Wright of Australia, the bronze medal winner in this men's surfing competition at these Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games. Many congratulations. Confirmation of the results. Owen Wright of Australia, a 6.50 wave and a 5.47 defeats the former double world champion Gabriel Medina of Brazil. Owen Wright, your bronze medal winner here in Tokyo.